Hi, Steve here at blessedhopeforever.com. We're going to talk about a timeline for spring. I think timelines keep us on our toes, keep us interested, keep us excited about the Lord's near return. I want to remind you that prophecy is mainly Middle Eastern centric. Israel has been at war about 56 out of the past 77 years. We are coming up on spring. There's a lot of conflicts raging worldwide. There's so many signs of his near return. That's for another video. We're talking about spring, new beginning, 8 years since the Revelation 12 sign, roughly 5777 to 5785, 2017 to 2025. Eight means new beginning. We're going to talk about the important month of Nisan, the first month of the ecclesiastical year. I hope that you find this video encouraging. On the first of Nisan of the year 2448 from creation, 1313 BC, 2 weeks before the Exodus, God showed Moses the crescent new moon, and he told him, "When you see the moon like this, sanctify the new month." And this ushered in the first Jewish month and commenced the lunar calendar that Jews have been following ever since. Spring, Nisan, means new beginning. There's even the month is thought of as a very important month. It's when they have a special mitzvah, which can be fulfilled only once a year, which is to recite a blessing or a prayer made upon seeing a fruit tree in bloom. There's what they call the blessing on blooming trees. We're looking at a Hebrew year of 5785. The year 2025, Gregorian calendar, and I believe that we're looking at some numbers here which, beyond a shadow of a doubt, leave us with the solid conviction that we are nearing the end of the 6,000 years that God allotted man to rule earth. Now, the date that I want to really zero in on here and focus on is March the 30th of 2025. March 30. Now, we know that Moses was 80 years old, 80 years old when he spake unto Pharaoh saying, "Let my people go." This timeline that I'm about to show you makes Israel 80 at the midpoint. 80 at the midpoint. Not 80 at the rapture or 80 at the second coming, but 80 at the midpoint. The timeline begins on a Sunday, March 30th, 2025. That would be the first day of the week, by the way. Nisan 1. Now, Nisan, if you want to say it that way, Nisan, the year 5785 on the Hebrew calendar. Now, it's the best timeline that I have seen in all the years that we've been doing this. I really should take you right to the end of it and work backwards, but I'm going to go forward with it, and maybe it'll leave you with the same impression. But we're looking at Sunday, March 30, which is the first day of the week. Now, we know that Jesus rose on the first day of the week. Exodus chapter 12, the first two verses of chapter 12, states that Nisan is the first month in the intercalation of the new year. Now, the word intercalation simply means the insertion of days or months into a calendar to bring it into line with the solar year or the year of the seasons. The first of Nisan is a celebration of, among other things, it's actually a celebration of various things, but among those things is that it is a celebration of a new year for kings and for festivals. Now, the word Nisan itself is really interesting because it comes from either the word Nitsan, meaning bud, We know that from Song 2:12, or the word nisim, meaning miracles, both of which suggest physical and spiritual resurrection in our lives. Now, May 14, 2025, Israel will turn 77, and I think that that's an important mile marker along this journey of our prophetic timeline. Now, that translates to Israel being 80 at the midpoint, which would make the second advent, the second coming, in 2032, the year 2032 A.D. Now, 32 A.D. could have very well been the crucifixion year. We're in that the right time frame or the range of time. You know, 30 A.D., I've always said 30 A.D. to 36 A.D. is really the only window or the only time frame in which the crucifixion probably could have occurred. And we're looking at 32 A.D. to 2032 A.D., which, as we know, equals 2,000 years. Now, I want to talk a little bit about Nisan 1 in Jewish history. Very important date in Jewish history. According to the Talmud, the three patriarchs of the Jewish people, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, all were born and passed away in the month of Nisan. We also have the death of Nadab and Abihu in the month of Nisan. Now, on the day that the Mishkan was inaugurated, Nadab and Abihu, the sons of Aaron, took each of them his censer and put fire in it, and put incense on it, and offered strange fire before God, which he commanded them not to do. A fire went out from God and consumed them, and they died before God. That's Leviticus chapter 10, verses 1 and 2. The erection of the Mishkan was completed. I'm talking about the Mishkan. I'm not sure how you exactly pronounce that, but it's simply the tabernacle. The tabernacle, or the temporary sanctuary in which the divine presence dwelled during the Jews' journey through the desert. It also refers to the portion of the tabernacle in the temple building before the Holy of Holies, which contained the inner altar, the table for the showbread, and the menorah. Now, Moses completed the consecration rites of Aaron and his sons. Aaron performed the first sacrificial rites, all in the month of Nisan. Death of Nadab and Abihu, sons of Aaron, all in the month of Nisan. King Hezekiah commenced the reconsecration of the temple in the month of Nisan. Cyrus was crowned king of Babylonia and king of all lands in the month of Nisan. The crowning of King Cyrus made possible the restoration of an autonomous Jewish community in Eretz Yisrael. The definition of Eretz Yisrael is the Holy Land, Israel, the concept favored by some extreme Zionists of a Jewish state, the territory of which matched the largest expanse of biblical Israel. Now, and the rebuilding of the Beit HaMikdash refers to the two religious structures that served as the central places of worship for Israelites and Jews on the modern-day Temple Mount and the Old City of Jerusalem. Now, in rabbinic literature, the temple sanctuary is called Beit HaMikdash, meaning the Holy House, and only the temple in Jerusalem is referred to by this name. Now, Ezra, who was to restore the primacy of religion in the life of the Jewish community, left Babylonia on the anniversary of Cyrus's coronation. The temple was destroyed in 70 AD. Now, what makes it so unique? What makes this timeline so unique? Well, it's not that, well, we're just putting out another timeline for 2025 and, you know, well, if he doesn't come, we'll put one out for 2026 and just like we do every year or twice a year, once in the spring, once in the fall. You know, what makes this so unique? What makes it different? What does it What makes it stand out above, or you know, all the rest of the timelines that we published every year, in which we're looking at? These aren't set in stone predictions. It's the best timeline. If you want to look at it from the perspective that we look at it, in which a timeline could have to do with important dates on the calendar. Now, I must agree with just about everyone on the fact that the Lord can return on a day of non-significance. The timeline, all the dates along a timeline can occur on dates that have no real significance whatsoever. But we see so many patterns in Scripture, and we see so many things in the Word that would cause us to believe that so many types and analogies and patterns that it's difficult at least not to at least consider the idea that the Lord would use some particular day, a special day for His return, or for the midpoint, or the second advent, the rapture, even the kingdom. And so we're looking at this from I tend to think outside the box when I'm doing this. And what I did was, just to kind of cut to the chase here, what I did was I went to what I knew was an important date on the Hebrew calendar, which was Nisan 10. And I went ahead and I looked at that in Jewish history, and I wanted to know what happened on Nisan 10, 10 Nisan, 10th day on the Hebrew calendar, in the month of Nisan, in Jewish history. And what I did was I found something very interesting that I thought you guys might be interested in, and I worked backwards from that second coming, the second advent, would be that date. I was shocked when I realized that when I worked backwards, it came back to a very significant date this spring, which is the spring equinox. The Hebrew year, the new spiritual Hebrew new year on the Hebrew calendar, the ecclesiastical year, as some call it, or the spiritual new year, which is different than the civil, new year, which occurs usually in September, October, or in the fall. We're looking at the ecclesiastical year. We're looking at the date in which, as I mentioned earlier, where the Exodus chapter 12 verses 1 through 2 states that Nisan is the first month in the intercalation of the new year, that Moses God showed Moses the crescent new moon and told him that when you see a moon like this, you sanctify the new month. That ushered in the first Jewish month. It actually began the lunar calendar that Jews have been following ever since. There are a lot of things that make this timeline interesting. What makes it so unique is 1948, when Israel became a nation, to 2025 is 77 years. We here at Blessed Hope Forever really have always looked at that number 7 as having great significance. A 2025 rapture would equal a second coming in 2032. Now, 32 AD to 2032 is obviously 2,000 years. A 32 AD crucifixion to a 2025 rapture would be 1993 years, and then if you add the 7 years tribulation, that's 2,000 years. Now, on this timeline, Israel would be 80 at the midpoint in 2028 or 2029, depending on certain factors. But we're We're looking at Psalms 90:10, verse 10, I believe, when we're looking at Israel being 80. Now, the midpoint marks the beginning of the Great Tribulation. If we look at the ascension, the crucifixion and the ascension in 32 AD to the descension, the second advent, in 2032 AD, that's interesting. A rapture any day in 2025 would mean that he descends exactly 2,000 years from when he ascended. The Revelation 12 sign back in 2017 to 2025 is 8 years. 8 years. Eight means a new beginning. Now, I have to remind you that all of this is end times prophecy is primarily Middle Eastern centric. However, Trump is sworn in January, this January coming up. On January the 20th, 2025, Trump will be sworn in. It's 70 days then to the Nisan 1, March 30, the beginning date on our timeline. If you follow this channel, you know that we've been tracking a lot of sevens as it relates to Trump, and now we see a final 70 days from his swearing in to Nisan 1, and that could very well be the end of all the Trump sevens. Even though he's going to be in office for 4 years, I believe that he could very well be the rapture president, but his first swearing in on January the 20th of 2017 to January 20th of 2025 is 8 years, eight meaning a new beginning. So we've got a rapture on March 30th, the ecclesiastical new year, 5785, 1290 days, that's what we believe here, to the midpoint, from the rapture to the midpoint. The tribulation then beginning April the 29th of 2025, which is a Rosh Chodesh, first crescent moon, month, that's month two, day one. The rapture, again, being March 30th, that's month one, day one. That's Rosh Chodeshim, because it's the spiritual new year. So the tribulation would begin a month later, Rosh Chodesh, on first crescent moon. And then that takes us to a midpoint of October 9, which lands on the fifth day of Tabernacles. And then you've got the return then on, I guess if you look at it this way, March 30, 2025, if you go forward 2550 days to the second advent, it takes you to March 22, 2032, which is the 10th of Nisan. The 10th of Nisan. Now, what's important to me, at least about this timeline, and what's exciting about it, is that this is the 10th of Nisan. Now, what happened on the 10th of Nisan? Well, Joshua crossed the Jordan River on the 10th of Nisan. Crossed the Jordan River. Now, we sing hymns about crossing over Jordan. We know that this is a type of Israel. And I want to remind you, this is not... Don't try to look at this all through the lens of the church. Israel is very much involved here. And so we're looking at the return of Christ on a date in which Joshua, the very exact date in which Joshua carried the ark into the promised land. But that's not all. That's not all. There's something else that happened on that date. Something else that's very interesting that happened on that date. What happened on that date was, well, first of all, imagine a rapture on the spiritual new year where that 2550 days later, the second advent occurs on the day Joshua crossed the River Jordan. Now, we know that from Joshua chapter 4, verse 19. On the 10th of the Hebrew month of Nisan, according to the Bible, Joshua led the Israelites carrying the Ark of the Covenant across the Jordan River into the Promised Land. As they approached the Jordan with the ark, the river parted for them just as the waters of the Red Sea had split when their fathers and mothers marched out of Egypt 40 years earlier. And now, almost 1,500 years after the first Passover in Egypt, Jesus entered Jerusalem on a donkey on Nisan 10. We're looking at Jesus entering Jerusalem on a donkey on Nisan 10. That's the second advent. Same day as Joshua crossing over the River Jordan. And as you know, the crowds, if you're familiar with that event that the Bible records or describes, the crowds who were in Jerusalem to celebrate Passover, they met him with palm branches shouting, Hosanna. Okay? Now, these fall feasts are also called the High Holy Days. Not only are they called feasts, they're also called festivals and holidays. The word feasts is the Hebrew word moed, which means to keep an appointment or appointed times. So, if you start at Nisan 10, if you want to work backwards here, if you start at Nisan 10 when Joshua crossed over Jordan and Jesus rode into Jerusalem on a donkey, and you work backwards 2550 days, it takes you to Nisan 1, Spiritual New Year, 5785, coming up. We're looking at it. It's just ahead of us, March 30, 2025. That's it. So that's it. I hope that you find this encouraging. Thank you so much. We love you. We truly do. Rest in Him. Until next time, this is Steve. Thanks for watching.